problem is all inside your head, she said to me. The answer is easy if you take it logically.
Hey guys, I'm Mike Keller. This is my workspace. This is my darkroom area. My dry area, scanning area. This is in the basement of our house in Colorado. I've got a little window well here that I kind of see outside. We had a hailstorm last night. Just kind of ironic that after 60 years, I'm here working in the basement, which is exactly where I started out with my friend Rick Frem in the East Village in New York. He had a basement apartment, and we had a little darkroom set up in there, and that's where it all got started for me. Well, here's where we're at. Gonna make some prints today. Stuff in the darkroom. Here's a pair of scissors. These scissors last. These are nothing special scissors, stationery store scissors from I don't know where. Stainless steel, made in the USA. These have been here, they've been in acid and fixer and all sorts of chemicals, and no problems with them. Silver spoon, works real good, chemistry, easy to keep clean. Other scissors, these medical scissors, stainless steel, you'd think these would be great. These suck. You can see right here, they rust from the pivot. Here's another pair of what would look like great medical scissors, perfect to have around the darkroom. Garbage. They rust from the screw. Same thing, all this crap from China. The hemostat actually is pretty good, but that's actually an old hospital piece of equipment. Paper punch, I wouldn't let this thing near anything wet. But works for me, and I use this. It's a tiny punch. It's a 16th of an inch, I think. I use this to punch my negatives so I know which frames in 35 millimeter I've worked with before or that I'm keeping. And then here's one more pair of scissors. These are Reaper scissors. These are stainless steel scissors. What makes these cool is that the pivot is plastic on it. And I used to use these when we were boating and fishing a lot. These are a fishing tool. They're made for saltwater fishing, so they're really good for everything. But I find that the blade on the scissors is too short. Using these in the dark, especially if you're cutting film, they're just too short. You don't snip it right. Or I don't. Maybe you would. But anyway, there you go. That's where we're at. Huh. Here's another little interesting piece. Can you read it? UCLA Art Department. I've had this for probably 50 years. They threw it away because one pin had broken off. So I got a small little screw, filed it down to exactly the right size, drilled and tapped the plate, put it in. Works just as designed. Anyway, let's go make some prints.
Problem is all inside your head, she said to me. The answer is easy if you take it logically. I'd like to help you in your struggle to